Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is part of the TP-Link Omada range. This is the AC1200, also known as the EAP225-Outdoor. It's a wireless access point. So I'm going to run through what you get in the box and we'll talk about the unit in a moment. So this is the device itself without its rabbit ears, which I'll show you. You're going to get two of these omnidirectional antennas. These do have standard, I think they're SCA, a mini SCA connectors. So you could attach other external paddles to this if you wanted to. All right, this is a PoE powered device. So you're gonna get your PoE brick. It's a cloverleaf in on this side. You can see the LAN and the PoE over there on that side. It does have a mounting plate on here. So let me just take that plate off. It slips off like this. So you could obviously fix that to the wall and then clip that back into place and tidy it away. You will get your power cable for it. It's fairly short, it's probably about half a meter. This has got a Australian power plug on that end, but you can see our clover leaf or Mickey Mouse eared, however you wanna call it, on that end. All right, you are gonna get your quick installation guide, which you may not look at all. You are gonna get your conformity guide for the region that you are in. You are going to get a little book that covers some of the other devices in the TP-Link Omada range. You are going to get two packets of lugs and screws. This is pole mountable and wall mountable. All right, so those lugs and screws are going to allow you to mount both the PoE injector and the actual device. You are going to get two zip ties, which I'll talk to you about in a moment. And you're going to get your wall fitting. So let me just put that there, show you the side and just turn that round. The idea being you're going to fit that to the wall and then this device is just going to slip in and clip into place there. All right, so I'll talk to you about the unit in a moment. Let's do look at the back of this. All right, so this is designed to be wall or pole mounted. You can see I used the wall mounting bracket a moment ago. If we were to pole mount it, you can see there is a curve here that can go into the pole. The idea then you're just going to pull your zip ties through around the pole and clip that nice and tight. All right, does look very similar to a Ubiquiti AC mesh. And in fact, the controller software for Omada is very, very similar, almost identical to the Ubiquiti stuff as well. So if you're used to that, maybe TP-Link's worthwhile have a look at if you've got any supply or price side of things. So let me just hold up the unit there for you. All right, you do see the side, everything is happening. I'll show you the again, the connectors at the end and the mounting there. On the bottom here is where your Ethernet cable is going to come in. So we just slip the clip off there. You've got your reset hole and your Ethernet in. Obviously this is PoE powered. And I just wanted, this is an outdoor device. You can see that it's not completely sealed at the bottom, but it doesn't need to be as long as your cabling's right. So remember on these type of things, you need a drip loop. So if you've got your Ethernet cable maybe coming through the wall, you're gonna come in higher than the device. You're then gonna come out through the wall and you're gonna come down in a loop and back in. Why? Because when we've got condensation, we've got rain or something else like that that hits this, if we keep that water running down onto the cable and out, then we won't get any ingress into the device. You imagine if your cable came at an angle, sometimes even straight through. Water can sit on that and slowly work its way through, and we're gonna get water damage in this. This is an outdoor device. Like I said, it runs in the 2.4 and the 5 gigahertz range. It's only got two antennas and two spatial streams, so 2x2. So it's not gonna have massive capacity for lots and lots of devices, but get a number of these outside and it will give you good coverage. Like I said, the antennas go on this. You can have, you probably could fit an omni antenna on this, a single larger one if you wanted to, or some bigger paddles if you wanted a little bit more coverage and range. So that's the device with that those fitted on it. These can angle as well like this to get your best signal depending on how you've mounted it. So hopefully that's been useful. That's the TP-Link AC1200 EAP225-Outdoor. Do head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got loads more box openings on wireless networking and firewalling devices, how to set up Omada, TP-Link Omada to control these and the TP-Link switches. even how to protect your network with firewall appliances. Do head on over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.